Greetings. I've been challenging a Muslim to produce surah and ayat that says, obey Allah alone. You see, if you search the Quran for the words, obey Allah, you will hopefully begin to notice something interesting. Surah 459, obey Allah and the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 332, say, obey Allah and the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 8:1, and obey Allah and His Apostle, meaning Muhammad. Surah 3:132, and obey Allah and the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 24:52, and those who obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 47:33, obey Allah and obey the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 33:71, and he who obeys Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 5:92, and obey Allah and obey the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 8:46, and obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 33:33, and obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 4:69, and whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Do you begin to see the pattern? Do you begin to see the absolute linkage? Do you begin to see the association? Let's look at a few more. Surah 64:12, and obey Allah and obey the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 49:14, and yet if you obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 9:71, and obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 24:54, obey Allah and the Messenger, meaning Muhammad. Surah 4:13, as for those who obey Allah and His Messenger, meaning Muhammad. I think those with eyes to see can see who they must obey and submit to. If I recall correctly, I once counted these surah, and there are 43 examples like these. And like translations of the Bible, I believe the number may depend on the translation. Except I was using an Islamic search engine that searches 42 different translations at once. But I did not double count any surah or ayat. The curious fact is, I did not find even one case that said, obey Allah alone. And every case that said obey Allah also included instruction to obey Muhammad. So I pointed this out to a Muslim I was messaging with. His response was, obey doesn't mean worship. Fair enough. Worship is different than obey. One can worship a celebrity. One can worship a stone idol. That does not mean you obey the celebrity. And it does not mean you obey the stone idol. But what does Islam mean? Does Islam mean worship of Allah? So I went to an Islamic website to see how Islam defines Islam. This is from forislam.com. Islam, an Arabic word which, since Prophet Muhammad's time, has acquired a religious and technical significance denoting the religion of Muhammad and of the Quran, just as Christianity denotes that of Jesus and of the Gospels, or Judaism that of Moses, the prophets, and of the Old Testament. Grammatically, the word Islam is the infinitive of the so-called fourth verbal form of the regular intransitive stem Salima, to be safe, to be secure, etc. In its second verbal form, salama, it means to make someone safe and to free, to make secure, etc. In its third form, salama, it signifies to make peace or to become at peace, i.e. to be reconciled. In its fourth form, aslama, the infinitive of which is Islam, it acquires the sense of to resign, to submit oneself, or to surrender. Hence, Islam in its ethico-religious significance means the entire surrender of the will to God. Here we see the words resign, submit oneself, and surrender. Notice there is no mention of the word worship. Notice there is no mention of the word worship. This is from IslamTomorrow.com. Defining Islam in English, what does it mean? Is it a noun or a verb? Islam is both a verb and a noun. It's all things to all men. Islam as a verb. Surrender to Almighty Allah. Submission to His will. Obey His commandments. Sincere worship only for Him. Peace in mind, heart, and soul. You can see the definitions are all mush and all related. Surrender, submission, obey, worship. As they would sing on Sesame Street,
one of these things is not like the others.
Obey. To comply with or follow the commands, restrictions, wishes, or instructions of, as in to obey one's parents. To comply with or follow a command, restriction, wish, or instruction. To submit or conform in action to. We can see in definition 1, obey does not mean worship. To obey our parents does not mean we worship our parents. From 2, we see following a command or instruction. Again, obey does not mean worship. But definition 3 is to submit, making obey a synonym for submit. Obedience is submission, and submission means obedience. Worship of something is not synonymous with obedience. Submit, to give over or yield to the power or authority of another, to subject to some kind of treatment or influence. A Muslim submits to the authority of Allah, thinking it is the maker of heaven and earth. A Muslim demonstrates submission by obeying the command it thinks Allah, or his de facto partner, gave. Surrender, to give oneself up as into the power of another, submit, or yield. Again, we see surrender is synonymous with submit or submission. Surrender, submit, obey. All basically mean the same thing. Worship is not even in the equation. Islam is defined as submission, and that means obedience and what or who you obey. Looking at Islam's own self-description, submission, surrender, and obedience are the real meaning. Worship only happens because it is commanded on fear of flames. And that is why it is so damning. The submission and surrender and obedience is to both Allah and Muhammad. The Quran makes no distinction between obedience to Allah and obedience to Muhammad. Worship, yes, only worship Allah. But Islam does not mean worship, as I have shown. Worship is nothing but a commanded side effect. If you do not worship, you are not obeying, you are not submitted, you have not surrendered. Worship is no different than prayer and the other pillars. Salat and worship are basically the same pillar. Worship stems from obedience to commanded behaviors. So in the religion of obedience and submission, is it important who and what you obey and submit to? Without question. And the Quran, which is Islam, equates and associates Muhammad with Allah. There is not one ayat I can find that says, obey Allah alone. Think about it, O Muslim. You submit to and obey Muhammad as Allah's equal. If you disobey Muhammad in anything, it is as if you disobey Allah. So who is your real Allah, O Muslim? Why does Muhammad never teach you obey Allah alone? Why does Muhammad always make himself equal to Allah as leader of Islam? One excuse I have heard in the past is that the messenger simply means any messenger of that time. You will also hear this excuse if you ever raise the fact the Shahada requires you swear oath to Mohammed along with Allah. The problem with that deceptive claim in the context of Shahada is that no prophet before Muhammad, including Jesus, ever required Shema to Yahweh and that prophet. The second issue is the disingenuous nature of the deceptive claim. Muhammad claimed he was the seal of the prophets, the last prophet. Thereby, Muhammad usurped for himself the right of co-divine authority as the only possible messenger requiring obedience in the future we now occupy. So I challenge any Muslim to produce surah and ayat teaching obey Allah alone. Let's look at one last surah. Surah 480. He who obeys the messenger obeys God. I find this concerning and troubling on several levels. First, this literally gives no qualifier or limit on the authority of Muhammad. It literally makes the hadiths of co-authority with the Quran. If Muhammad said it and you disobey, it is as if you disobey Allah. He who obeys the messenger obeys God. That absolutely links Muhammad as equal in authority with Allah. By implication, there is no command that Muhammad can give which, when followed, violates a command by Allah. If Muhammad gives you an instruction or command, and you follow it, it is as if Allah gave the instruction or command. Therefore, Muhammad cannot give you a command such that you may disobey it and continue to obey Allah. Every command by Muhammad must be obeyed as if it were a command by Allah. He who obeys the messenger obeys God. A more literal reading cynically means they are one and the same. He who obeys the messenger obeys God. For Muhammad and Allah are one. Think about it if you dare. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.